All right, we're going. Hello, everyone. I am sorry if you were hoping for another episode of V'ger Please this week. Instead, I can only offer you the last piece of Voyager media that Peter and I never actually consumed, which was Star Trek Voyager Elite Force. I've never played this game except for maybe like a few minutes one time. It has a, I know it's pedigree because it was made by Raven Software. So before they got locked into the eternal, I don't know, purgatory of having to do Call of Duty games every other year or whatever the hell Activision has them slaving over. They actually made cool games like Hexen and that sort of thing. So this was something they made in the before times. And people say it's the best Star Trek game. It's definitely basically a Quake 3 engine clone. And the most compelling and interesting thing about it, of course, is that it has the entire Voyager cast voicing an entire plot. I think the plot was actually even turned into a book. It's essentially an entire Voyager episode packed into a game. And this, the GOG version is the version that has the expansion pack, which includes apparently a Captain Proton mission, as well as the capacity to just kind of wander around the ship and that sort of thing. So I'm looking forward to that, but let's get this going. I hope everyone is ready to hear a whole bunch of, you know, V'ger Please related inside jokes.
Welcome to Voyager Elkar's menu system.
All right, let's... let's get the sound manageable here. And it is something to play a game with this kind of bad resolution. So yeah, this must be the ability to go through Voyager. Alright, well, let's just do this.
On Stardate 48315.6, the USS Voyager was transported beyond our control, 70,000 light-years across the galaxy.
Beyond our
the
control.
There, without aid from Starfleet, we began our 70-year journey home.
You controlled some things.
In our numerous encounters, we came into contact with many dangerous and violent species. Having a limited crew with no chance of reinforcements, we determined that we needed a specialized team to handle the more dangerous situations. Tuvok, Voyager's chief of security, assembled an elite force of security
personnel. I have so much to say already.
Named the Hazard Team. Ensign Monroe is second in command of this uniquely trained team. Equipped with 7 of 9's experimental anti-Borg weapon, the Infinity Modulator, the Hazard Team has beamed to a Borg cube on a dangerous mission. However, the team was quickly overwhelmed, and the I-Mod is now in the hands of the Borg. Separated from the rest, Monroe is attempting to rescue the team.
This game doesn't look too bad, to be honest.
Monroe to Tuvok. I've been cut off from the rest of the Hazard Team.
God.
I don't know where they are.
Mr. Monroe. We have isolated your team members' life signs. They appear to be trapped in the tertiary power modulation chamber. Rescue them at any cost.
Acknowledged. Tertiary what?
All right. Now we got the sound more out under control. That just was a little too much for me. Anyway, I'm good, man. I was over the Rona most of the way. Actually, like the night we did the series rip, I was sick for like 12 hours. That's it. The only reason I knew it wasn't a cold was that I had a headache, and I never have headaches. So I got tested. I had Rona, but this Omicron stuff is pretty easy to deal with, I think, for most people. So here, there's my review. That's my coronavirus review. 4 out of 10. So I love the opening crawl to this game because it suggests, first, that Voyager was stuck in the Delta Quadrant because of things outside their control and not Janeway choosing to strand them there for the sake of a bunch of Mayfly space elves. So I love the revisionism. Second, I love that, you know, Voyager's security kept getting breached, so apparently the mission, the way to deal with that was, like, recruit better security people from within Voyager by Tuvok? I don't know, it just seems like you're putting the coyote in charge of the hen house if you're gonna do that. But that's alright, that's okay. And then they beam him over to a Borg cube, and apparently they immediately lose their secret weapon. So that seems legit. So what do we got here? Hit the mission info key.
I've uploaded your mission objectives and tactical information. Review it now before proceeding.
What the hell's the mission info key? You gonna tell me? Alright, configure. Keys. Okay, tap. Alright. Clean your teammates. Reclaim the IMOD from the Borg. Tactical information. Shooting and destroying Borg distribution nodes will deactivate green force fields and allow Borg enemies nearby. Borg enemies will adapt to your weapons and create full body shielding, making your weapons useless against them. Only engage in combat if absolutely necessary. The new IMOD weapon was specifically designed to penetrate Borg shields. Best weapon to use against the Borg since they cannot adapt to it. It looks like I got a compression rifle and a phaser. So I must have gotten these from next to the warp core. Let's take a look around here. We got... Definitely looks like a Voyager set to me. How do I activate things? You know what? Gotta see here. Use a space. Or do I attack it? This guy just died standing there. That's sad. That's sad. Sad as his textures, really. Alright, I guess that seems like a thing I'm about to blow up here. Alright. So control is not... let's see. Backpedal. C is crouch. Some less intuitive controls than I'm used to. Okay, and then... Alright, that's with how we recharge our weapons. Seems good. I guess this looks better than I expected it to for a game made in 2001, but it is essentially Quake 3, so... Do like that the Borg, like, you know, leave you alone as long as you're not fucking with them. So I'm gonna fuck with them, of course. Did it just like turn them all off in the region I'm in? That's OP. It's like I'm in Star Trek The Las Vegas Experience. They have like a whole second Borg thing that they installed late in that attraction's life. This must be health. Cool. All All right, shift is run. Got it. All right, so, all right, where do we go? What do we do? Poking around here. I think this is the way. Oh, all right, another thing to blow up. Oh, is there a jump button? X or slash? Jeez, okay. Ooh, a ladder. Okay. This is just already higher production value than any Borg episode on the show.
Monroe! My savior! Get the IMOD. It's on that table.
Oh, sweet. Okay. Ah! I can already tell I hate you, and you're probably Maquis. Bet Chakotay would say great things at your funeral if I shot you. So I got the MacGuffin. Charge it. Alright, let's go this way. Let's light him up now. Oh, cool. The effect was well handled. This is some species 8472 level bullshit. Here is a phaser that you can just machine gun down Borg drones with. Good luck, have fun. I gotta go find said special power source. Yeah, I already hate that guy.
Hey, nice shoot, Monroe.
Was it though? Is this the spot? Okay. I just need to do the usual,
Hey, Monroe, if you're not back in 5 minutes, I'm not going in after you.
Yeah, he's definitely Maquis. Whatever. You had to hear about how Dolby's stories for too long. I'm not going to have any, sympathy for you. How about... Let's see. Oop! Okay, well, that apparently gets you killed. to be honest, so far there's a charm to it. Hold on one second. Let me see if I can get that. One second. Sorry, I was trying to get my screen sorted out so I could see chat better, but I'm afraid I am too much of a boomer. But there's a charm to this. I mean, it's a 20-year-old video game. It's the same way as a 20-year-old television show. So if you think about it in context of some of the other games in the era, this is actually pretty good. Just for the first few minutes I've been playing it. And then I had a classic gaming death there where I just like, oh, I wonder if I go this way, and I just died. I have to redo things. There's a charm to that as well. Also, to be honest with you, I haven't watched an episode of Voyager for several weeks now, because we did the finale before Christmas. So it's kind of nice to go back and do a Voyager thing, you know. I haven't yet really tried to get into anything when it comes to Enterprise. I'm not going to until February. That's when we're going to start recording. So this is a pleasant distraction in its own way. All right, so got the blue thing.
Blue force field? I don't see a dis note here. I'd come with you if I had an eye mod, but.
I'm gonna save the game. There we go. That way if I, like, take a header off of a fucking thing, I'd just have to redo all that. Apparently I have some sort of invulnerability to getting assimilated. That's the thing. Do I just blow it up from here? Okay.
Hey, the force field's down. What the? Some board just beat in and they're.
Oh, sweet. He died. That's excellent. This game already is vastly improved. 7 out of 10. Has the good sense to kill off people who suck. Oh, is this... Are one of these guys the guys that got assimilated? If so, I want to shoot that one in the head. Okay, so... Oh, so the phaser does not share an energy source with the other weapons. Interesting. Oh, that's cool. I guess, like, health pickups and that sort of thing would have been a little much. So you have to have handy-dandy wall things. Oh. Turned around. Will I, though? I will say the music has me missing some, shall we say, simplistic UPN beats right now. It's definitely showing its age. That sort of like MIDI style track. There must be some other MacGuffin somewhere. These are health and energy things. Oh. Got him. Hell yeah. I'm just saying, not equipping the Borg with energy weapons is a bit of a miss. I'm just glad that the first enemies of the game could be actual Morg instead of, you know, Borg. Oh, hey, what's up? They took the team to tickle them to death, I guess. Oh no. Oh no, is this platforming? Oh no. The resolution is probably like 1260 by 1080. It goes higher, but for whatever reason, I wasn't getting it to load properly. It would just quit if I went any higher when I tested it out, so this is what we're stuck at is not great. Oh man, this is dark. This is first person shooter platforming. This was a thing, man. Like, for whatever reason, developers thought you wanted to do platforming in a game where you couldn't see your damn feet. You know? I don't get that. That's not fun. Here we are. I'm left assuming that. How do I do this? Okay. We just go up? No. There's, like, danger up there. Maybe not? Maybe I do just go up? Alright, time to take a ride. Okay, well. Go up and then go back down. Is there a place to jump to? Like, what the fuck? What is this? Check the other side here. See if anything interesting happening. Yeah, we're in a Borg cube. I've run into the arch nemesis of early 2000s game design, which is jumping puzzles in a first-person shooter, and I'm already, like, completely flummoxed as to what to do. Kind of tempted just to jump and take a header and see what happens. Yeah, let's do that. Okay, well, I died. That's what happens when you do that. Final analysis, your judgment leaves much to be desired. It's accurate. trying just to see if there's like a way to go here that I'm not seeing. Because of course, like, my brightness isn't, you know what, I should just jack the brightness up. That's it. So I can see, because I can't see shit from Dick right now. Yeah. Yeah. All right, there we go. There we go. That's so much better. Look at this. Look at this. Oh! Oh, all right. Guess that worked. Hold on 1 second. I can actually see chat now. I see Pete. So Peter, you decided to pop on and see what this is about, huh? God, man. You know, okay, so having the brightness down certainly made the whole being on a Borg cube thing seem much cooler, particularly for this, like, era of technology. You know, it's dark and gritty, and it's highlighted by green stuff, and you really can't see real well. And then you, like, get lost in what the fuck you're supposed to do next, and so you turn it up, and it turns out, like, it's actually pretty well lit, and there's actually pretty good shadows, and... Yeah, okay. Sure. Alright, is there nothing in here? There's nothing in here. Like, I wanted to keep it dark because that's felt correct, but then you can't see anything. Alright, I guess I just take the other elevator down. That's all it is. Alright. Apparently, 7 of 9 invented the fuck Borgtron 9000. I love it. We keep two of these next to the warp core. So I just had to hit the switch again. It's really nice of the Borg to install weapon terminals that's, you know, compatible with Federation super tech. It does make a certain amount of sense, though, that 7 of 9 would be able to develop an anti-Borg weapon relatively easily. You know what? I want to see what happens when I... Oh, okay, cool. They do, like, adapt. So that wasn't just for, for show to say that. That's cool. Alright, so what do we got here? We getting in that? So we might be getting in this. Get the old save here. This one's kind of doing a freaky dance. I like it. He died with rhythm. I'm entering a new area. Seems like an old area. Oop. Oh god, it's Chell! It's Chell!
See if you can locate the control console for the force field.
Who would pick Chell to be on a security team? Did they not see Space Friendship is Magic? Why would you pick him? Listen, I'm just saying the salty dude who's in the bottom of the ship, you know, like charting gaseous anomalies would be a better choice. I'm putting it out there. Oh, this guy got fucked up. It's no good. Oh, okay, so I gotta find the way to lower their force fields or whatever. Just shoot it. I love it. I love this guy. Trigger a Borg IED.
I told you. Well, what was I supposed to do?
Oh, it's a simulation. Okay.
Mr. Monroe, your tactical approach was, shall we say, tactless.
God.
All right. Hazard team, report to debriefing.
The facial animation is leave something to be desired, but I love the environments, man. Way to go, guy. Way to shoot the Borg thing.
Sir, if I may. How was I supposed to know the battle would explode?
That point is not relevant, Mr. Monroe. A given situation is not as predictable as you might desire. Your reckless decision has caused the death of you and your teammates. You have failed. Had you followed standard hazard team procedures, you may have survived the simulation and achieved your mission objectives.
Yes, sir. Procedure.
Oh, this guy's too cool for the rules. I love it.
Deck 4.
With all due respect, sir, I don't think procedure would have mattered. There wasn't any way I could have possibly rescued them.
Someday, Mr. Monroe, you may be called upon to do the impossible.
You don't know how you could have rescued them? By not blowing up the thing you didn't understand? I don't know how this works!
Computer, reroute turbo lift to the bridge.
So the hazard team has special equipment? Oh! I see they really made an improvement of how Garrett Wang looks versus real life. That's very good. It's really, really smoothed him out. That's good.
What happened?
We responded to a distress signal from a derelict vessel and it opened fire.
Tuvok, they don't respond to hail.
God, 7 of 9 looks hideous.
Target their weapon systems and disable.
Yeah, Janeway looks right.
Direct hit. Phasers had no discernible effect. Half shields are down. Routing auxiliary power to the shields.
I love how the bridge looks. Holy shit.
Captain, I'm getting reports of extensive damage on decks 9 and 10. We're not going to survive another hit.
Photon torpedoes, full spread.
Torpedoes away.
Everyone's putting in good effort on the voice acting. Oh no, Peter, they use photon torpedoes. Your favorite.
right.
I am undamaged.
What just happened?
You can tell that they recorded Seven's lines later. That's the
we've been pulled through some sort of isodimensional rift.
Where are we?
Apparently, here, Captain. Sensors and most of Voyager's primary systems are offline.
Apparently here.
Until repairs are made. It may be difficult to ascertain exactly where here is.
Everyone's doing well with their voice acting. I'll grant that. Are you get like the opening? So it's the opening, but with different music.
Captain's log, stardate 53854.7. Voyager was attacked by an unknown force and transported to some kind of starship graveyard, whereabouts unknown. The ship is heavily damaged. Communications, propulsion, and other systems are offline. Until repairs are done, we're utterly helpless. Stranded.
Let's get this ship back together, Chakotay. Get damage control online.
Oh.
Harry, find out what you can about those other ships and exactly where we are.
Aye, Captain.
Captain, there's a containment leak in engineering. If we can't get it sealed, we're going to have a warp core breach.
Ensign Monroe, you're wearing a hazard suit. Get down to engineering and help Bellana seal that leak.
What was that? It was Tab, I think. Yeah.
Captain, we're drifting. Attempting to compensate with maneuvering thrusters.
Let's take a look around real quick. Got Seven here, who... Oh, this is just rough. The head is not in proportion with the rest. It's also, I'm pretty sure this is supposed to be late Voyager, right? Because this is some late Voyager Janeway hair.
I believe the captain ordered you to go to engineering.
Shh, quiet. But this is definitely the season 4 bodysuit right here.
I have some data on one of the closer ships. It does not appear to have an outside.
God, that is some like NBA Jam big head level nonsense right there. We've got the Ensign Wildman Science Corner. I think they ever did like 4 shots ever over here. We got Tom down here.
Ensign, the captain gave you a direct order.
I heard you, bro. Alright, got Robbie down here. This is the engineering station, right? You can tell they put way more effort into doing the art for these Elcars versus these Elcars. Because, you know, these are the ones like, yeah, this is barely ever on the show. But these are the ones like, oh, I gotta make sure the security one looks nice. Alright, and then... This should be the ready room. Hell yeah, this is awesome. Here we are. And what an office, right? Wouldn't it? It would be badass to have like... Yes, here's my palatial view out into space on my uncomfortable future couch. This looks right, though. This is the hallway you dragged the captain out into when you need an injector with some kind of time fluid, as we saw in Shattered. And then that's a turbo lift. And this is where the briefing room is?
I won't repeat myself again, Henson. Get down to engineering.
It won't let me in there. Now here's the briefing room. Ah. God, this looks good too. Alright, that's in the right spot. There's a replicator. Very cool. I think there's supposed to be a door here, but it's all right.
Tuvok, put Ensign Monroe in the brig.
Oh, am I about to get arrested?
I should have known that you would not be able to maintain proper procedure. This incident is as much my fault as it is yours.
What the hell?
For you to be transferred to waste reclamation once your incarceration is complete.
I got a game over? For not following orders fast enough. Mission failed. Starfleet will not tolerate such insubordination. Apparently out of a nobody. It'll tolerate it all day long from everybody else. It'll tolerate from Tuvok committing actual mutiny. I give Tom a slap on the wrist for actual mutiny. But man, you don't go down to engineering right away. You get sent to the brig and then you have to scrub the plasma conduits for the rest of the trip home. God bless. Okay. Status. Oh shit, I gotta sit through all this again.
Captain, we have reports of secondary ETS conduits on decks 8 and 9 rupturing. Warp drive is offline.
Treason, acceptable tardiness. Jail. Straight to jail. Do not PESCO. Do not collect $200. Go straight to jail. Oh. Sorry, we'll have to sit through this again.
Maybe we need to send a clearer message. Target their weapon systems and disable.
Firing phasers. Direct hit. Phasers had no discernible effect. Half shields are down, Captain. Rerouting auxiliary power to shields.
Appreciating level design goes against General Order 1, obviously. God. Just the fact that they did that. They programmed in a fail state while you admire what's going on around you.
Everyone all right?
I am undamaged.
What just happened?
I'm kind of tempted to spend my time finding really unique ways to lose the game.
Where are we?
Like, that's funny.
Sensors and most of Voyager's primary systems are offline. Until repairs are made. It may be difficult to ascertain exactly where here is.
Alright, now we're gonna speed through the opener this time.
Captain,
there we go. Alright.
Get damage control online.
We're gonna save it too.
Find out what you can about those other ships and exactly where we are.
Hi, Captain.
Captain, there's a containment leak in engineering. If we can't get it sealed, we're going to have a warp core breach.
Ensign Monroe, you're wearing a hazard suit.
Yeah, okay, I'm going, Kathy. I will literally go to jail if I don't.
Turbo lift controls malfunctioning. Initiate vocal
deck 11 engineering.
Oh, alright, we'll be reloaded in some fucked up shit apparently.
In the data shunt here.
Showers and Chell, sir.
Good.
Did they pay the Chell actor to... I'm sure they did. Paid everybody else. It sounded like him. looking out for IEDs. God, hallways look great. Really does. Like, the shadows are good on a 20-year old game. Jesus. Ho! Oh, did I just kill him? Did I just kill that guy? This game is amazing. Oh man, well I'm going to jail for that? Okay. Sure, seems right. Whew. All right. Okay. What if instead I just watch to see what's going to happen? Yeah. Yeah.
Sick bay, I've got wounded. Hold on. Medics are coming.
Okay, I think my roleplay element here is going to be I'm going to be a very, very bad at... doing my job. Hold on, I gotta find my way to engineering or whatever. Okay, now. How do I... Did I screw myself by letting that person get killed? Hold on. Oh, here we go. Yeah, come on. What am I supposed to do? You won't let me into other parts of the ship? I need to... All right, see you, Peter. Yeah, I need you to tell me where to go, bro. Alright, lame. Alright, let's reload to here. Let's try this again. Maybe because I let that guy die, it won't let me advance. It's the sort of thing that an older game would do to you. Sorry, no more.
Sir, here's the damage control progress.
The
letters on the Jeffries tubes.
Garrett, can you give me a hand with this plasma relay?
Come on, buddy, you can make it.
Hit that paddle and bring up the containment field. That was close.
There we go, buddy. Saved you that time.
Need to take a turbo lift to engineering.
Well, the aft turbo lifts were the only ones working on this deck, but they're behind the containment field. The explosion must have shorted off this console. I think there's an override somewhere on this deck, but I'm not sure where.
Okay, so I did have to make sure this guy lived. It's funny. You're just stuck from letting the guy die.
Sorry, Monroe. The data shunt's been severed here. Everything down this way is shut off.
Hey, we're getting a power surge here.
Monroe, quick! Hit that panel and shut off this relay.
That was close.
Chell, I need to get this containment field down.
There's an override in the Jeffries tube just down that corridor.
There's access to the Jeffries tube somewhere. Oh, right here. There we go. Okay. Lol. Pretty accurate Jeffries tubes. Grant that. Alright, now we're on power 9. Or tech 9, rather. I'm gonna find a Jeffries tube junction room. Okay, so I just go this way. All right. Neat. This kind of does feel like they really designed Voyager. Makes me want to do the poke around the ship thing. We'll do this little mission, and then I might actually mess around with that for a little bit. Oh!
Warning. Hazardous material detected.
Oh, hey, we're doing some platforming. Gotta love it. Woo! Made it. Let's drain the toxic waste out so I can use the door. It's Metroid. Hazardous materials storage lower deck 11. Really? We have a whole room for this? We're in space. If it's hazardous, you just put it into space. It is an industrial accident, you know? There we go.
Monroe, what took you so long? We've got a warp core breach in progress. You need to get in there and shut it down. There are two things you have to do, so listen carefully.
Okay.
First, cut the power relays on the main floor. Then go to the upper level and decouple the dilithium matrix. Wait a minute. You're going to need a helmet to get through that coolant leak.
I've got one in my transporter buffer.
Hurry up and find those terminals. There isn't much time before we
Sorry,
need
is
containment
it
and have to reject the core.
A personal transporter buffer? Hold on. Save this. Alright. I'm gonna purposely faff about, and I'm gonna see how the game ends in this spot. Because there has to be a game-ending thing.
Hurry, Monroe. I'm not sure how much time you've got left.
Attention. Warp core breach imminent.
And engineering looks good. Space pipe storage where the bodies get stowed.
Attention. This limb has malfunctioned.
Gotta use the Oh hey, we're at the murder loft / makeout corner. I love it. I'm actually trying to figure out what I'm supposed to do in here. Like, I was just randomly just okay.
Displaying power relay access code. Got it.
Yeah, I guess it's not gonna actually fail me down here.
Access granted. Power relays have been cut. Attention. Warp core breach in 30 seconds.
Oh, perfect. Now I can wait 30 seconds. Breach the core. Breach the core. I mean, if I get thrown in jail for not going down to the engineering fast enough, there's got to be something for this, right? Nope.
Five. Mm-mm. Four.
Mm-mm.
Three.
Nope.
Two.
It's not happening.
One.
Yep.
Attention. Warp core breach imminent. Warning. Warp core has breached containment. Emergency core ejection system is malfunctioning.
Okay, cool. There was a Starfleet one. Starfleet will notify your family. I love it. Okay, let's quit the current
Welcome
game.
To Voyager, Elkar's menu system.
I want to just do the virtual Voyager thing. I can be male or female. Okay, I'll just... You have a giant thing of the D in your quarters? I just have a tricorder. Okay. Apparently, I was big into Starfleet rugby. Yeah. New Chicago High School Rugby MVP 2365. I was a jock. No wonder I'm so insufferable. Man, I got some tasteful art in my bathroom. Jeez. Better reflection technology than some games today. Love it.
Ensign?
Seven.
I must commend you on your tactical analysis of our situation earlier. It is rare that I find myself in agreement with other members of the crew in these situations.
Thank you.
Preparations will take some time. I suggest you use the opportunity to relax.
What?
Captain Janeway has encouraged me to allocate a certain percentage of my time.
Am I getting flirted with by Seven of Nine?
It is inefficient, but I see the wisdom.
I guess if you're gonna buy a game like this, it's time for that male fantasy.
Whatever.
Whatever. Dude.
Alex?
Oh wow, so you can. You can scan. Okay. Is it holodeck? Okay. Turbo lift. So I'm on deck two, right? Oh, sweet. Yeah, this... Excellent. Excellent.
Hello.
Neelix rank crewman. Lie. Is that Neelix?
Neelix, I'll be with you in a minute, Ensign.
See, there's even a hobo trash can fire in here. This is great. Two of them. Oh, Jesus. Apparently that's where he keeps the special meat.
Excuse me.
So, yeah, apparently I can access Harry and Neelix's quarters on this level. And this is Neelix.
Security access required.
Oh, I need a security access.
Security access required.
Let's see if I can get a security access. I want to go in your room, you filthy space rat. Come on.
Neelix.
Yes.
I'm sorry, are these his recipes? We got Alfarian hair pasta, algae puffs, Jambalayan fudge cake, that's that crappy cake from Twisted, Calvian biscuits, Lorian pudding, Leola root soup! Let's see what Leola root soup is. Two gallons of water, one large Leola root, whole, another one finely chopped, celery, Talaxian yellow carrots, Pantene onion chopped, whole bunch of salt, and red pepper. Yeah, it sounds like a soup, all right. Oh, that's funny. That's a nice touch. All right, let's keep looking around. I don't really want to go into frickin' Harry's room anyway. Not his Canadian girlfriend.
Security access required.
Where's the turbo lift? There we go.
Specify deck desired.
Okay, so bridge, mess hall, officers' quarters, hazard ops, sick bay, astronaut chest, cargo bay, computer core, shuttle bay, engineering. Let's check out sick bay.
Deck five.
Let's go talk to the doc, right? Yeah, locked doors. This clearly is not actually a Voyager accurate simulation. There we go. Hey, Doc. What's up, man?
Excuse me. Doctor?
Ah, Mr. Monroe. Your injuries seem to be rather superficial. Dermal regeneration will not be necessary, though you have some mild skin irritation. Perhaps you would like an analgesic cream?
Whatever.
Just get injected with your dick drugs. That was good. Thanks, Doc. Appreciate it. So we got the three, I guess, what, surgical? No, this is the surgical bay over here. And then we got kind of like the three extra beds. And this is the Tuvix's murder memorial quarter. Oh no, are you dead? Hopefully not. Personal logs. I do like reading people's stuff. Okay, so it's like him talking about all the bullshit people get up to. I love it. Who are you? Is this like some disease? Oh, some mephage. Okay, yeah. All right, neat. Neat.
Specify deck desired.
Seen the bridge, seen the mess hall, officers' quarters, hazard ops, sick bay, asteroids, cargo bay. All right, let's. It's another major set, right? Handy that they built Astrometrics right next to where Seven of Nine, you know, lives.
Ensign Monroe, if you wish, you may access the Astrometric and Xenologic records from that console.
Scan this acid is very fun.
The Avatar is largely a mystery, but it is speculated it was a first attempt by the Vorsoth to create an ultimate. The Borg are a race of cybernetically enhanced beings. This Delta Quadrant race is organized in packs that the Imperials come from a continuum that coexists with our own, but on a different dimensional plane. In this mirror universe, virtually everything from our universe exists, but it is 8472 is the.
Does this game have like mirror universe in it? That'd be kind of dope. Alright, here's a cargo bay. Is this the one where Joe Carey smokes his blunts? That is the question. Let's see. I gotta find the holodeck, man.
Deck 3, officer's quarters.
Let's see, is this on the officer's quarters level? Let's see.
Security access required.
I probably need to go to the bridge and just, like, ask Tuvok for him, right? Like, hey, man, can I have, like, codes to get into everyone's rooms? Yeah, sure, buddy. Here we go. It's my Tuvok impression. Turbo lift storage. Everyone's rooms. Yeah.
Specify deck desired. Deck 4, hazard op.
The prig. We send you down here if you're tardy. Mildly tardy.
Welcome to Voyager Elkar's menu system.
Let's go ahead and head back to the actual game. It was fun to check that out, but continue to be impressed by how good the environments look.
Hurry, Monroe. I'm not sure how much time you've got left.
All right, let's prevent this ship from blowing up this time.
Warp core offline. Core breach averted.
Alright, yay!
Good job, Ensign. That was touch and go there for a little while.
Is that Vorik?
No problem, Lieutenant.
Okay, let's get a cleanup crew in here. Seal that leak. We need to get main power back online. Vorik, give me a hand with the resonance cascade modulator.
Listen, if you want to send someone up here to get murdered, I'm in the right spot for it right now. Let's throw him right over. That's so bad.
Gina, watch your alignment.
Hey.
That Isodyne Alex. Array has to be modulated.
Oh, it is. Exactly. Okay, it is Vorik, and it's voiced by Vorik. That's great.
Torres.
Look, Ensign, I'm kind of busy here. Ensign Stats, is the coupling matrix back online yet?
Just another couple of minutes, sir.
How's it look, Justin?
That walk animation is rough. What's my... Let's see.
The leak is contained, but we've got some heavy damage here.
I don't know how soon we'll
intruder
get
alert.
Back online.
All security and hazard team personnel to the loading dock.
Make it a priority, B'Elanna. We're still trying to sort out our situation.
All right, now I gotta go shoot something. So that's good.
Deck 8, loading dock.
Here, Monroe, take it. Come on.
If you need medical attention, just come right here.
Monroe, over here. We're being invaded by some kind of pirates. They're taking our supplies. We have to stop them. There are two of them behind a barricade there. They're launching energy grenades. See if you can eliminate them. Ready?
No space pipe, huh? All right. Oh, nice. Oh, that's right. Eat it. I don't know if this is unkill or stun, but I'm doing it. How is it? Is Herogen? Dope. Oh, that's a Malon? Oh, this is great. This is like some season 6 shit right here. There's like probably an alt fire, right? It is just literally alt. Okay. Oh shit, that's like actually disintegrate them. This is great. Oh wow, okay, alt fire on that's dope. Hold on. Yeah, wide beam setting. That'd been awesome.
Tuvok to bridge. The intruders have been repelled.
Well done. It seems our situation is worse than we thought, Tuvok. Report to the conference room.
Acknowledged. Lieutenant Foster, have the team report to hazard operations. I am certain that many of you are curious as to our situation.
dope briefing room. It's part of the ship you've never been to.
It seems that many other disabled vessels are present here as well. We have detected an energy dampening field surrounding the area that is draining Voyager systems of power. For the moment, we are trapped like the other ships.
Oh, so it's like the subspace Thunderdome episode.
From the Tarkanis gravity well, 247 ships have been lost there.
Or the Bermuda Triangle. You know, back on Earth.
Perhaps. Our primary weapons and propulsion systems are offline at the moment. The captain's current strategy is to find out as much as we can about our surroundings while we effect repairs.
So, what's the deal with our unwelcome visitors?
We do not have
what's the deal? What?
As of yet, Mr. Beesman. They appear to be scavengers of some sort, comprised of Klingons, humans, and Malons.
Klingons?
Only short-range sensors operational. We have been unable to locate their vessel since it departed.
Klingons, you say? Will that be explained?
However, we have detected a vessel nearby. While sensors indicate no life signs, we have detected a functioning power source on board. Our hope is that their computer systems are still operational and contain information about this area. The hazard team...
Oh, about to raid someone else's fucking ship.
Still intact.
No life signs?
Like a ghost ship.
Yeah.
While your
God, what a dick. It's like an 80s movie villain.
Is recommended. Your team leader, Lieutenant Foster, will now brief you on your specific mission objectives. Lieutenant?
All right. This is an information gathering mission. Minimal encounter probability. The hazard team.
I just means we're gonna get our asses kicked.
Alpha Squad, my group, will beam into Control Room A. Ensign Monroe and Beta Squad will be transported to Control Room B. Our objective is to have at least one of the teams locate a functioning terminal to extract any information we can and return to Voyager. In the unlikely case of hostile
encounter, look how buff this guy is. In his spacesuit. He's got abs. He's got muscle definition.
Any question?
Talk about a... These models have spent some time in the gym.
See the quartermaster, Oviedo, in the equipment room. Gear up, then report to transporter room one. Dismissed.
So I gotta get my weapons.
Man, data gathering? I was hoping for some action our first time out.
Be careful what you wish for.
Just wonder how long those scavengers have been here.
I don't know. I'm surprised.
Watch it!
Alright, I'm gonna check
Welcome to Voyager, Elkar's menu system.
Virtual Voyager one more time here.
Specify deck design. Deck 4, hazard ops.
Because I want to check to see if you actually can do a black and white Captain Proton thing. Chill.
Security access required. Security access required. Security access required.
I think we might be in some trouble when trying to find this damn holodeck. Here's the brig. Thrown right in here. Saw how easy that was. All right. Well, I'm going to call it there for now, but I'm going to definitely play some more of this. This is good. This is this was fun already. Thanks to everybody who showed up. Appreciate you. And I'll let everyone know when I go live tomorrow.
Logging off Elcar's menu system.